Cells are the basic units of life, found in plants and animals. They can be taken from an organism and grown in a lab, but they can also die if not treated properly. Studying cells outside the body, in a lab setting, is crucial for cell and molecular biology research. Much of what we know about cells comes from studying cells grown in culture. In this video, we will talk about common properties cells have. Number 1. Complexity. Cells are incredibly complex and organized. Complexity means having lots of parts that need to be in the right place and work together without errors. Cells are precise in their activities, like copying DNA with very few mistakes. Each type of cell and organelle has a consistent structure and composition. For example, the cells lining your intestine have specific features for nutrient absorption, and these features are similar in all humans. The good news for scientists is that these levels of organization evolve slowly. Even though humans and cats look very different, our cells and organelles are quite similar. This means that what we learn about cells in one organism often applies to others. Basic life processes, like making proteins or using energy, are alike in all living things. Number 2. Cells possess a genetic program. Cells have a genetic program that guides how living organisms are built and function. This program is stored in genes, which are made of DNA. To give you an idea of how much information is in genes, if we turned it into words, it would fill millions of pages of text. Yet, all this information fits into the tiny space of a cell's nucleus. Genes aren't just information storage, they are the instructions for building cell structures, running cell activities, and making more genes. Genes can also change over time, leading to variations among individuals and driving biological evolution. Understanding how cells use and pass on this genetic information is one of science's most significant achievements in recent years. Number 3. Cells are capable of producing more of themselves, except germ cells like sperm and egg. Cells can multiply through a process called cell division. In this process, the contents of one mother cell are divided into two daughter cells. Before division, the cell's genetic material is copied exactly, and each daughter cell gets a complete and equal set of this genetic information. Usually, the two daughter cells end up being roughly the same size. However, in some cases, like when a human egg cell divides, one of the cells can keep most of the cell material, even though it only gets half of the genetic information. Number 4. Cells acquire and utilize energy. Cells need energy for all their activities, and most of the energy they use comes from the sun. Photosynthetic cells contain pigments that capture sunlight, converting it into chemical energy stored in carbohydrates like sucrose and starch. In animals, including humans, energy often comes in the form of glucose, a sugar released into the bloodstream by the liver. Inside cells, glucose is broken down into a form called ATP, which is like a cellular energy currency. Cells use this stored energy to power all their functions. Cells use a significant amount of energy just to maintain and repair themselves, a process called turnover. This helps cells stay healthy and responsive to changing conditions. So, energy is essential for every aspect of life, from basic maintenance to responding to the environment. Number 5. Cells are performing chemical reactions. Cells are like tiny chemical factories. Even the simplest cells can perform hundreds of different chemical reactions, which are mostly sped up by special molecules called enzymes. All of a cell's chemical reactions together are called its metabolism. Number 6. Cell is full of mechanical activities. Inside cells, things are always happening. Materials move around, structures are built and taken apart, and sometimes the whole cell moves to a different location. These activities are driven by changes in the shape of proteins, often called motor proteins, and other molecular machines. Number 7. Cells interact with the surroundings environment. Cells can react to their surroundings. Some single-celled organisms move away from obstacles or toward sources of food. In multicellular organisms, like plants and animals, cells have specific receptors on their surfaces that allow them to respond to various substances in their environment, including hormones and signals from other cells. These responses might involve changes in metabolism, movement, or even cell death. Number 8. Cells are self-organized units. Think of cells like assembly lines in a car factory. Nucleic acids, genetic material, contain the design, and proteins are the workers. What's unique about cells is that these workers don't need someone telling them what to do. They automatically do their job one step at a time, like a complex machine. Cells are like resilient machines that can protect themselves from harmful changes. They have feedback systems to correct any issues and keep everything in the right order. This is crucial because mistakes can lead to problems like mutations or cancer. Scientists are still trying to understand how cells control their activities. Number 9. Cells evolve. Cells have been around for a very long time, but how they first came into existence is a mystery. It's believed they evolved from some primitive form of life, which in turn emerged from organic materials in the ancient oceans. While we may never know exactly how cells first appeared, we can study how cells have changed and evolved over time by looking at organisms today. If you compare different cells, like a bacterial cell in the human gut and a cell in the lining of the gut, they can seem quite different. However, all cells, whether from humans or other organisms, share common features like a genetic code, a cell membrane, and ribosomes. Modern biology tells us that all living things have a common ancestor cell that lived over 3 billion years ago. This ancient cell is often called the last universal common ancestor, or LUCA. It's from LUCA that all known living organisms have evolved. Evolution isn't just something that happened in the past. It's an ongoing process that continues to shape the properties of cells in organisms that haven't even appeared yet.